scripture reading. We just finished the longest chapter in the Bible, Psalm 119, and we will be starting on Psalm 120 today, and we'll see how far we get. As always, I'll just be reading the Bible to you, and then talking about verses that stand out to me, and hopefully encouraging you along the way. So before we start, I just have one quick announcement. I now have podcasts on my Patreon, so if you guys are interested in ASMR podcasts of these videos that I do, check it out. I also will be doing podcasts of my Bible studies from my Faith to Rise Christian Encouragement channel and other podcasts in between. So if you don't know what Patreon is, I have a video I just put out on this channel. It's just a 2-minute video that talks about it a little bit. So come on over and join us on Patreon. It's been a really awesome platform that allows us an opportunity to get to know each other a little bit better and provides you with extra content. So anyway, let's get started. I've got my Bible here. Sometimes you guys ask me what version I use. This is the New King James Version, and I like this version because it's a good combination to me between the old and the new. Sometimes I find the newer translations to be a little bit too far away from the King James Versions. Not that there's anything wrong with that, I just like the poetic nature of the King James, but the King James is sometimes a little more difficult to understand, so I just find that the New King James is a good balance. So I'm going to be attempting to speak in a non-wet whisper, if you know what I mean. Usually I do a lot of wet whispering, but I'm just going to be whispering today, which will allow me to be more of myself and not so focused on the ASMR aspect. So let me know what you think if you notice a difference in the comments. What do you guys like to see? Alright, let's get into it. Psalm 120. Just waiting for the opportune moment to learned over the years and have shared with you before, sometimes peace means being absent from certain people. Sometimes to have peace, you have to maintain distance from someone or stop surrounding yourself with certain people. Some people do not want peace, and if their actions are speaking louder than words and they say they want to be at peace, but there's always chaos and confusion and a lack of peace, then the actions speak for themselves and you have to go off that. So to maintain peace with people means different things in certain situations. We have to use wisdom to find out how to deal with different people in our lives. And we don't deal with every person the same way. Psalm 121, I will lift up my eyes to the hills. From whence comes my help? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not allow your foot to be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. He shall preserve your soul. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. It's so comforting as a Christian to know that nothing comes to us that hasn't first gone through God's hand. There's so much peace in knowing that. So many people are afraid of death, afraid of, you know, strangers, afraid of what might happen, what if. And as a Christian, you just have this overwhelming peace, knowing that your life is in God's hands. The surrender brings calm and relieves worry. Our help comes from God. Verse 3, He will not allow your foot to be moved. We don't have to be shaken by world events or things that happen in the news or COVID or whatever comes up. Nothing is a surprise to God. And as Christians, we know the end of the story, so there's nothing to fear. God wins. We can trust and leave these things, these worrisome worldly things, to God. He doesn't sleep. God's not falling asleep on the clock. The other day, I was walking, and I was sad. I had a really bad day, and I shared some encouragement about it the next day on my Instagram. But as I was walking and feeling down about some things, it came into my mind the story of how right before the most intense time in Jesus' servants look to the hand of their masters as the eyes of a maid to the hand of her mistress, so our eyes look to the Lord our God until he has mercy on us. For we are exceedingly filled with contempt. Our soul is exceedingly filled with the scorn of those who are at ease, with the contempt of the proud. I'm going to move to Psalm 124, but I just want to encourage you, if you ever read something and you think, wow, that's interesting, or you want to dig deeper, you know, you can bring up commentaries on your phone or your iPad or your computer very easily. I tend to use Bible Hub because they have a bunch of different commentaries. I really enjoy Matthew Poole's commentary, but there's also Matthew Henry and John Gill and a bunch of different commentaries there. And it'll take the verse and sort of break it down for you so that you can understand exactly what it's saying and get so much more insight into what you're reading and background as well. Psalm 124. If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, let Israel now say, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side when men rose up against us, then they would have swallowed us alive. When their wrath was kindled against us, then the waters would have overwhelmed us. The stream would have gone over our soul. Then the swollen waters would have gone over our soul. Blessed be the Lord who has not given us as prey to their teeth. Our soul has escaped as a bird from the snare of the fowlers. The snare is broken and we have escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. Where would we be without God, you guys? I feel so bad for people that don't have God in their life. And if that's you, my heart is just very tender towards you because life is so hard and there are so many emotional setbacks that can happen and surprises that can come. Deaths of loved ones, betrayal, changes we didn't see coming, finances, leadership in the world, problems in the world. And like it says here, if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side, we wouldn't make it. It's the Lord that gives us the strength to overcome things. It's the Lord that gives us the hope to have a different viewpoint in life, to put our mind on higher things so we will not be so affected by things on this earth. It's indeed an important revelation when you come to realize that you need the Lord. You would not have gotten very far without the Lord on your side. And if you don't know the Lord, there's a prayer down below in the description box that you can pray and ask him into your heart. And once you do, he will be on your side too, and your life will go in a completely different direction. It'll take time. It'll take growth, but you can have that peace from knowing Jesus right now. If you want, it's up to you. I, for one, am so thankful that I have the Lord on my side, because I know I wouldn't make it without him. Let's move to Psalm 125. Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion. As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people from this time forth and forever. For the scepter of wickedness shall not rest on the land allotted to the righteous, lest the righteous reach out their hands to iniquity. Do good, O Lord, to those who are good, and to those who are upright in their hearts. As for such as turn aside to their crooked ways, the Lord shall lead them away with the workers of iniquity. Peace be upon Israel. Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, strong, firm, unmoved. Let's keep going. Psalm 126. When the Lord brought back the captivity of Zion, we were like those who dream. Then our mouth was filled with laughter, and our tongue was singing. Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, and we are glad. Bring back our captivity, O Lord, as the streams in the south. Those who sow in tears shall reap in joy. He who continually goes forth weeping, bearing seed for sowing, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. That's a promise. Verse 5, let's hear that again and take it in. Those who sow in tears will reap in joy. Those who sow in tears will reap in joy. Weeping may come for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Yes, there may be time between the weeping and the rejoicing, more time than a night or a week. Sometimes the sorrow is for a season. Sometimes the sorrow is for a long season. But there's a promise that God will make all things good, that all things will work together for our good, and that if we sow in tears, we will reap in joy. God sees our pain, and as I've heard said a lot lately in different ministries, our pain has a pay date. There will be an end. It will not be forever. Though God tarries sometimes, and though time passes and he allows it for a season, 27. Unless the Lord builds the house, they labor in vain who build it. Unless the Lord guards the city, the watchmen stay awake in vain. It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows, for so he gives his beloved sleep. Behold, children are a heritage from the Lord. The fruit of the womb is a reward. Like arrows in the hand of a warrior, so are the children of one's youth. Happy is the man who has his quiver full of them. They shall not be ashamed, but shall speak with their enemies in the gate. I love that. Basically, God is in control, and it may look and seem like we are in control or other people are in control, but God is in control. God is the one that has the final say. I love verse 2 as well. No need to eat the bread of sorrows because God gives us sleep. We are not to worry. We are not to focus on our problems. Now that is easier said than done, and trust me, I deal with worry and anxiety just like anyone else. But when we start feeling worrisome or have anxiety about something, we can choose to say, oh, I'm really not supposed to be doing this. I don't need to be doing this. This is not going to benefit me in any way, so I'm going to stop dwelling on it because ultimately God's in control anyway, and if I trust him, I don't need to worry. There is a sleep-faith connection, which I've talked about as well on this channel. I'll link the video here if you're interested. You can check it out. So, 8 inspirational chapters encouraging us to just continue trusting in the Lord, keep our eyes fixed on him, know that he's in control, and find our peace in him. I hope that this Bible reading was an encouragement to you guys. As usual, love and blessings to you. Until next time, bye for now.